One of the most common questions that people ask this time of year is, can I get six-pack abs in time for summer? Well, in this video, I'm going to show you an easy way to answer that question. To get six-pack abs requires reducing your body fat to about 7%. If your body fat is higher than that, you are not going to see your abs. It's that simple. A lot of people make the mistake of thinking that it's ab exercises that's going to make their abs show up. Not so. For 95% of you, all you have to do is reduce body fat and you'll have six-pack abs. So, how long is it going to take to get those six-pack abs? Well, the first step is to calculate how many pounds of fat on your body. That's actually a lot easier than it sounds. All you need is a very inexpensive skin fold caliper like this. And you measure the thickness of the skin at three places on your body. And then with the calculator on my website, you plug those values in, and it tells you how much fat and muscle your body has. Then you subtract out the 7% of the fat that you want to keep, and that's how many pounds fat you need to lose to get your six-pack abs. Now that you know how many pounds fat you need to lose, it's a very simple matter to calculate how long it will take you to lose that fat and get your six-pack abs. You go to my website and use the free calorie calculator. You plug in all your values so it knows your precise metabolism, and then it will tell you how long it will take you to lose that fat and exactly how many calories you need to eat per day to accomplish your goal. So, now that you know how long it's going to take to get your six-pack abs, the next logical question is, how do you do it? What do you eat? What exercises do you do? Well, I've spent a lot of time answering that question. If you Google Scooby six-pack abs, you'll find my free, straightforward, and simple abs program. Please check it out. Now let's cover a couple of very common questions that people have about fat loss. First of all is about the rate of fat loss. When you use my calculator, the most you can reduce your calories by is 20%. And for a lot of people, that's not fast enough. They want to lose the fat faster than that. Well, sorry, you can't. The problem is, if you cut your calories more than 20%, you are going to lose muscle instead of fat. And muscle is so hard to gain, the last thing you want to do is lose it by dieting too strictly. So keep your calorie reduction to 20% at most. And if that's not fast enough, I'm sorry, you should have started earlier with your weight reduction. The second common question I get about fat loss is about various diets. What do I think about the Atkins diet, the grapefruit diet, the Twinkie diet, the low-carb diet? Well, we're all looking for easy ways to lose the fat. But the truth is, it's not easy. It's a lot of work. The only way that you can take the fat off and keep it off year after year is through good, solid, common sense nutrition and portion control. And the sooner you learn that, the easier it's going to be on you, because you can just get your weight to the right body fat and maintain it there for the rest of your life. No more getting fat, dieting, getting fat, dieting. It's so much easier and you look good all year round. That's it for this video. Hopefully now you know how long it's going to take you to get your six-pack abs and what to do to get them. That's it for now. Alfieder saying.